How can I know if I have rheumatoid arthritis? First of all, I would like to introduce what is rheumatoid arthritis. Rheumatoid arthritis is an autoimmune disease. There's a hyperactivity of the immune system, and the immune system, this hyperactive immune system, will see the joints, will recognize the joints as microbes coming from out of the body. So it will start to attack those joints, and this will cause inflammation. Inflammation in the joints means pain, swelling, stiffness in the morning in those joints. If you take a painkiller, if you drink a painkiller, you feel better. But more importantly, you need to be on some medication. A medication that works on the immune system, that down-regulates the immune system a little bit so that it can stop hitting those joints with antibodies. When this happens, the disease activity will go down and the pain and the stiffness and the inflammation will go down. This is rheumatoid arthritis. What is the correct scientific way to diagnose rheumatoid arthritis? It is a rheumatologist. The rheumatologist is the physician who is specialized with diagnosing rheumatoid arthritis. What will the rheumatologist do? He will listen to you. He will sit on a chair. This is the most important tool you need for diagnosing rheumatoid arthritis, is a chair. The patient will sit on a chair and he will talk. He will describe his symptoms. The rheumatologist will listen to him. And if he describes symptoms that look like rheumatoid arthritis, we start to suspect rheumatoid arthritis. This is the scientific way to diagnose the disease. If we suspect rheumatoid arthritis, we probably make most of the diagnosis while listening to you. 80% of the information I need to diagnose rheumatoid arthritis and to exclude the mimics of rheumatoid arthritis happens mostly when I'm listening to you and asking you and you're answering my questions. After that, I will examine you. Examination is not the diagnosis. It's step two of two. Step one of two is history taking. I finish most of what I need in the history, then I examine you to confirm that what I have suspected is there. This is the diagnosis. After that, I do lab tests. Lab tests are not for diagnosis. They are for assessing the level of inflammation maybe, and they are for checking if you have the antibodies of rheumatoid arthritis positive. If they are positive, then your rheumatoid arthritis is that type with positive antibodies. If they are negative, then your rheumatoid arthritis is that one with negative antibodies. But the history and the examination are everything. So this is the way we can diagnose rheumatoid arthritis. A rheumatologist who makes a clinical diagnosis of rheumatoid arthritis. What is the, unfortunately, common, incorrect way of diagnosing rheumatoid arthritis? Labs. This is an incorrect way of diagnosing rheumatoid arthritis. And if the doctor seeing you is a non-rheumatologist, probably he will depend mostly on the labs rather than listen to you. I made the lab test and it proved that I have rheumatoid arthritis. There's nothing like that in the dictionary of a rheumatologist. The rheumatoid arthritis lab test was positive. So what? It can be positive, it can be negative. It doesn't make the diagnosis. A positive test for rheumatoid factor can occur with rheumatoid arthritis, 70% of patients only, by the way, in other autoimmune diseases, in some infections, in 5% of the normal population. So positivity in itself, it does not diagnose anything. And negativity does not exclude rheumatoid arthritis also, by the way. The doctor suspected that I have rheumatoid arthritis, but the lab test confirmed there's nothing like that. If you and your doctor are waiting for a lab test to confirm a diagnosis, you have to know that you are in big trouble. But the doctor, when I went to him, he told me that the RF test confirms the diagnosis. This is not true. It does not. How about that test, doctor? Anti-CCP. How about that test? They told me that this is the final big confirmation for rheumatoid arthritis. Well, the anti-CCP test is a test that we respect more and we give it more weight when we diagnose rheumatoid arthritis. We cannot deny that. But still, there are reasons for anti-CCP positive tests that are not rheumatoid arthritis. It is more specific to rheumatoid arthritis than the rheumatoid factor, but alone it does not make the diagnosis. I need your history. I need you to describe symptoms of rheumatoid arthritis so that I can suspect rheumatoid arthritis, and then I can confirm it when I examine you and then do some lab tests. But the ESR, the erythrocyte sedimentation rate, it was high. The CRP test, it was high. Those tests, they show that there is some kind of inflammation somewhere in your body. They do not diagnose anything. They are high in rheumatoid arthritis, maybe. They are high in any sore throat, in any urinary tract infection. If a woman has a menstruation, they are high in so many conditions. They cannot diagnose anything. So the final word for the diagnosis of rheumatoid arthritis, the password for diagnosis of rheumatoid arthritis is the rheumatologist, because rheumatoid arthritis is a clinical diagnosis. Clinical, it means that the doctor will listen to you mostly and examine you. This is how he makes the diagnosis. Thank you so much.